Right, the numbers are quickly coming in and all eyes are on the Wote Tarling Centre in Makueni as the country awaits the confirmation of the man or woman who will be the next senator in the county of Makueni. We are live in Makueni and we will be there when the final results are declared by the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission. Let me now bring in my colleague Aaron Ochieng, who's been covering the by-election for you all through the day. Aaron, it has been a very eventful day. What has taken place the entire day and what's taking place now?
To see whether
as I can speak right now, it is a bit hectic right now because Mutula Kilonzo Jr. has just come into this particular hall with his supporters, and looking at the provisional results that are being shown on the screen, this is a landslide victory for Mutula Kilonzo Jr. We have 90.68% of the total votes cast, and the next person who's coming in is at 5.23%. I don't think that this is a margin that can even the second person can try to catch up with the Mutula Kilonzo Jr. Our 865 polling stations have sent in their results. That is less than 50, if I look at it, less than 50 of remaining polling stations that have not yet sent their results. We have 253,281 from Mutula Kilonzo Jr., who is just right here with me, looking at the results that have happened. You are a clear winner in this particular by-election. What do you have to say to the nation?
The people of Makueni have spoken. They have spoken loudly, and they have said what they want to say loudly and clearly for everybody to see. And I'm happy that they have spoken with one voice and have given me and given the party a resounding lead in this by-election.
Okay. I do want to repeat that these are provisional results. I am not entitled to declare the winner. IBC has to do that. But looking at the figures, KTN can authoritatively say that Mutula Kilonzo Jr. is going to be the next senator for Makueni County. It has been hectic. Looking at what happened to your sister,
yes,
and you coming in as a second option to it, did you think at some point that this might not go the way you had planned?
No, there's no. We never had any doubt in our minds about this. This is something that we knew from the beginning that would go our way, and that is the reason why the party fought hard for this process to go on and for them to have a candidate. There are no doubt, because this seat belongs to the Wiper Party. It was with the Wiper Party, and it is with the Wiper Party.
Okay, now we know that in the next few minutes, IBC is going to declare you the winner of this particular election. Looking at what your dad had, your father had in mind for this particular county,
yes,
do you think that you are up to the task to fit into your father's shoes?
I'm more than up to the task. When I said in the morning is that the shoes he had, I'll wear them, polish them and put laces. So I'm more than up to the task and tie them properly and tightly and move with the people of Makueni forward together with the government and county government of Makueni.
Just before the elections, we had a bit of hullabaloo about your name being stuck
in
the ballot paper.
Yes.
Someone has already said that that is not the way elections are supposed to be conducted. Are you seeing that probably your win might be contested? Maybe.
We welcome any person to contest this victory. We welcome anybody to challenge this victory and tell any court in this country that this victory could not have been achieved. And remember, this victory is not for Mutula Kilonzo Jr. This victory is for the people of Makueni. So a petition is more than welcome, anytime. Okay. Even the minute they declare, they should take this to court if they think that there is something wrong. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, the Wiper candidate myself was disadvantaged by this ticking of the name on the ballot paper. I should be the one complaining. Possibly this margin should be larger than this if this had been done properly like we had anticipated. Remember, we the party are the ones who took this matter to court and insisted that the process that they were undertaking must be done properly before we participate in this election.
Okay, looking at the coalition, the court coalition, you are securing a seat that was court's coalition.
Yes.
And in looking at the numbers in parliament, where court coalition is still disadvantaged in terms of numbers, you're going to the Senate.
Yes.
Are you going to make a mark and probably even try to make the coalition stronger the way that, than it is right now?
First, you must start with Makueni. We must, first of all, strengthen the leadership in Makueni so that, first of all, they deliver. Because that is the mandate that the people of Makueni have given us. Once we strengthen the leadership in Makueni, then by invariably, the people of and the court coalition will be strengthened, and particularly the party. So I have no doubt in my mind that if we focus on it, it will be easy to do.
Okay. Now, the way forward, looking at the developments that have happened.
Yes.
You're going to the Senate.
Yes.
Very young. Probably, I think you'll be one of the youngest,
yes.
If not the youngest,
yes.
Senator in the Senate.
Yes.
What would you promise the people of Makueni now that they've a 90%? I don't think even your father had this kind of margin.
No.
Yeah. 90%. This is a total landslide victory. What are you gonna do for people of Makueni that they would say, Mutula Kilonzo is the man that we elected, and this is what he did? And this is the difference that we now have him in the Senate.
Let me correct you. This is not a landslide. This is a continental shift. So landslide cannot define this victory. This is not even a landslide. Two, the people of Makueni must expect leadership, because our work as leaders in this county is to synergize. Is to synergize from every little leader so that then we can move forward, so that the people of Makueni can then benefit from the devolution that has come up as a result of the new constitution. Remember, if I choose to deliver alone, I will not deliver. So therefore, my greatest interest, as I said initially when I was nominated, my interest is leadership.
Okay.
Leadership means you get everybody on board, get everybody thinking, do the synergy, get our leaders to think and understand that their mandate is specific. They have a contract with the people of Makueni to deliver, and to deliver services alone. Simple, straight, and straightforward.
Lastly, people might say you've been pushed. Raila Odinga was on your side. Former vice president was on your side. Is Mutula Kilonzo Jr. a man of himself?
He is. Why? Because even if assuming, for the sake of argument, that somebody pushed me, did they also push the results?
Right.
Do you understand?
Okay.
Yeah. So you cannot push me and then push the people of Makueni. So if somebody was pushing the other, it cannot be me. And strictly speaking, if you ask them, because that question should be asked to them, I'm not a pushover.
All right.
At all. Because if I was a pushover, most likely I would have been Naris Ania.
All right.
Yes.
Thank you very much for finding time to talk to KTN.
Yes. Thank you.
And I'm going to release you. And I should say congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you very much.
That was Mutula Kilonzo Jr. speaking to us on going by the results that we have from the board that is just next to me. It looks like the numbers have changed. 869 out of 914 polling stations have already sent in their results, and provisionally Linda Ogutu, it is going to be a massive lead for Mutula Kilonzo Jr. We'll be keeping you updated as soon as IEBC confirms this kind of results. Linda Ogutu, I'll be coming back to you just to confirm this. For now, it is back to you, Linda.